Hi guys, my name is Steven. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use the new Flexbox container in Elementor. So if you haven't heard about the new Flexbox container before, you're probably wondering what exactly is Flexbox container. Well, previously we've been creating website with sections, inner sections, row, columns, those kind of stuff. Although creating website with sections and columns was super easy, but it does have some downside and limitations when it comes to design possibilities, creating complex layout, and that is exactly where Flexbox containers comes in. It reduces the amount of code that is being generated when you're creating your website and also gives you the flexibility and design control that you need when creating website for your client. With Flexbox containers, you can create complex design without any limitations. So let's go ahead and log into a WordPress website so I can show you how to get started with the Flexbox container. So I've gone ahead and logged into two different WordPress websites here so I can show you side by side the difference between using sections and containers to create your WordPress website. You can see this one right here still have the section option to grab the section and drop it right here, while this one over here have the container option right here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go side by side and regress some of these designs that we have over here using Flexbox container. So if you don't see this container option right here, you need to go into your Elementor settings and enable that. Let me show you how to do that. So if you go back here and then you can go to Elementor and then click on settings, and then over here you can click on experiments, and then you can scroll down and you can see the Flexbox container, and then make sure that it's active. It might be on default or inactive, so change that to active and then go ahead and click on save changes, and then come over here and refresh the page, and then you're going to see the new Flexbox container option right here. So now that we have that, I will go over here and click on the setting icon right here. I like to design on a blank canvas, so I'll go here and change the page layout from default to Elementor canvas, and that is going to look like this. And now we can go ahead and start designing this page using the container element. So the first thing we need to do is to drag this container element inside here. You drop it right here and then it's going to look like this, or you can even click here and then you can see some options right here. If you go back here and do the center and click over here, you can see the options that we have here. So if you look at the options that we have here for sections, and then you come over here and look at the options that we have for containers, and you can see that we have some arrows here. We have this arrow pointing in this direction and this one pointing in this direction. So what this means is that container is simply all about directions and alignment. I'll show you what I mean by that in a bit. So let's go ahead and grab some elements and put them in here. So the first thing we need to do is that we can go ahead and try to regret what we have here. You can see here that we have a section, and then inside that section we have three columns, and then we have this icon box. So we have three icon box, three columns and one section. So you can see that by going to navigation here, and here you can see that we have this inner section inside this main section, and then we have these three icons inside. And the reason why we have these three columns inside here is to be able to align this icon box horizontally like this, because if I drag this icon box and put it inside this one, and then it's going to look like this. It's going to stack on top of each other, and we don't want that. And this is exactly where the Flexbox container is going to come in handy, because it's going to give you the flexibility that you need without having to have all these columns inside the section. Let me show you an example here. So here we have this icon here. Let me go ahead and select this one. It doesn't really matter which direction you selected, because you have the ability to change the direction later, right? We have this here. I'm going to go ahead and drag three icon boxes inside here. So let me look for that. Here we have the icon box. I'll drop it here, and then I need another one. I'll just go ahead and duplicate this and duplicate this one like this. So right now if I go to the navigation here, you can see that we only have one container, and then we have three icon boxes in here. And then if you go here, we have the inner section, and then we have three columns, and then we have the three icon boxes. So now you're automatically saving the code that will be generated if you are using these columns right here, because over here we are not using any nested containers. We are just using one container, and then inside there we have the three icon boxes. So what we need to do now is to select the container. So this is where all the magic happens, right? Under these items right here, this is a new option that we have. If you go here, you can see that we don't have that option right here. So let me give this one a background color so you guys can see what I mean. So I'll go here and then I'll change the background color for this one. I'll give it one of these colors that we have over here. So this one has this color, right? So let's go back to the container. Now you can see that we have this one vertically stacking on top of each other, and we have this one with the color on top. If we select this one right here and reverse it, now you can see that one with color will be at the bottom, right? And that's super easy. You don't need to do anything. And then over here, if we want to change the direction to make it look like this one we have over here, here. All you have to do is to click on this horizontal right here, and now it's going to look exactly like this automatically. And then if we want this one with the colored background to be at the end over here, we can go ahead and click on this one right here, and then it's going to reverse and it will be over here. And you can see how easy this is compared to using sections and moving stuff around and adding padding and stuff like that. So now I'm going to give three of these icon boxes colors so that we can play around with it a little bit, so you guys can see exactly how this works. So let me go ahead and give this one a different background color. Maybe I'll give this one black, and then I'll give this one right here in the middle red. So now that we have this, let me go ahead and change these colors that we have over here. I'll change the color to white here. I will also change the title to white, and then I'll change the description to white as well. Okay, so this is what we have. I will do the same thing with this ones. So I've gone ahead and changed all the colors. So keep in mind, every other setting is exactly the same, right? Let's say you want to add some padding. You go to advanced and then you add your padding. Maybe we can add 25%. And then you can see that this looks a lot better, right? So all the settings are pretty much still the same. So now let's go ahead and select the container again, so you guys can see what happens here, right? So over here, we can go ahead and change this container to maybe the height. We can go ahead and change this to viewport, and maybe we can do this to maybe 80%. I'll change this to 80%. So this is what we have. And now you can see what happens here, right? So we have the content. We have the direction like this. We can change the direction like this. And look what happens over here. Look at the justify content and also the align items. So whenever I click on any of these directions, all this information that we have here is going to change based on the direction that we are using, right? So if I click on this, for example, you can see that that will rotate. And if I click on this and click on this, and you can see what happens here, right? So what we're going to do now is to play around with this justify content options that we have here. So we have this on this horizontal direction right here, like this. And then maybe I want this content to be all the way on the top over here. I can select this start, and it's going to be on the top over here. And if I want it to be at the bottom, and then I can go ahead and select the end, and then it will be at the bottom over here. And then if I want it to be stretched all the way from the bottom to the top, and then I'll select stretch, and then it will look like this. And you can see how easy that is compared to playing around over here with patterns and margins and stuff like that, trying to get it to look exactly how you want it. And then over here, you can see that we have some space between these columns right here. Usually you will go to advanced, and then you go here and mess around with margins and stuff like that. But over here, you don't need to do that. All you have to do is to select the gap between all these elements, and then you can drag that gap, and then it will automatically add that for you. So you can see how easy this is. It makes your life so much easy and gives you so much design flexibility and control. Okay, so that is just one example. What if you wanted to have something like this, where you have an image on the right, and then you have a title here, and have a text module, and then you have two buttons side by side? It could be anything. In this case, we are using icon box side by side. It could be two icon box side by side or two buttons side by side. It doesn't really matter. So for a design like this, to have two buttons side by side or these two icon modules side by side is a little bit tricky, because here you will have to go inside each of these elements, go to advanced tab, and then go to the width of each of them and change this to inline auto, or maybe you can use a custom size here, which is what we are using in this case. But this is a little bit tricky because it can create a lot of problem when it comes to creating responsive website. If I do this, it will look good on desktop, but then when you go on mobile, it's going to be all messed up. So you have to be careful with this. But with Flexbox Container, this is super, super easy to create with no stress. Let me show you how you can do that. So here, for example, all we need to do here, I will go here and reduce the size here. Maybe I'll remove the size that we have here, like this. And then let's go ahead and add a new container right here. So in this case, I'm going to select these two containers right here. So now if you see what happened here, we have a container. If you go over here, we have this container. And then inside the container, we have another nested container inside the main container, right? So all we need to do now is go ahead and grab the image element and drop it on the right over here. And now we have this one right here. So because we are trying to achieve this, so what we need to do is we are going to go ahead and grab all this and put it inside there. I'll show you what is going to happen in a second. So I'll grab a title, I put it here, grab a text module, put it here, and then we need an icon box, or let's say two buttons, for example. Let's just use a button. So we'll grab one button and put it here, and then grab the second button and also put it here as well. So now we have two buttons here. Let me go ahead and make this a little bit more text. I will paste this in here. Okay, so we have a little bit more content in here. So this is what we have. You can see that it's looking good already. But we want these two buttons side by side, and we can't do that because remember, we're working in directions here, right? So if I select this nested container and then go to the layout here, we have the direction. If I change that direction like this, for example, it's going to change everything, including the button like this. And that is not what we want, and that's not going to work. So this is where the Flexbox containers come in handy, because what we need to do now is to go back here and grab another container and then put it inside this container, because the Flexbox container actually allow you to put another container inside a container, right? So you can have a complete control over that particular container. Because over here with the sections, it won't let you put the inner section inside this particular section right here. So you need to drop it at the bottom here, which is not what we want. But over here, the container modules allows you to do that. So what we need to do now, grab the two buttons, put them inside this container. So now that we have it inside the container, we can actually select this container and then go over here and change the direction for this particular container. So once we change the direction to horizontal like this, you can see what we have exactly. It will just be exactly side by side. And now we can go ahead here and play around with it. We can add some spacing in between here. We can make it center aligned like this. We can also put some space in between like this. One will be here and one will be over here. We can also put space around it. Space here and here as well. And then we can also space evenly. We can put even space around it. And this is really easy to do without having to mess around with padding and margin and stuff like that. And this is also responsive, right? Let's go ahead and change the color for one of the buttons. So let's make this one black maybe. So we have the black one. So let's go ahead and select the container again. You can see that we have the responsive icon right here. So once I click on the responsive icon here and go to the mobile, you can see what we have over here. You can see what the button looks like. Maybe on mobile, we want these two buttons to be in the middle. We can go ahead and select that middle over here and it will move to the middle. And you can see that this is looking good and is super responsive. And then let's go back to this first container right here. Let's say we want this red icon box to be on the top. Once you select this, all you have to do is to go here and then reverse this. And now you can see that we have the red one on the top. And that is on mobile, right? And if we go back to the desktop, you can see that the red one is still here, which means it's supposed to be the last. But then when we go to mobile, you can see that it's on top. So guys, this is how easy it is to create your website using the Flexbox container. I've used it already on 7 websites and so far I have no problems, and I think I'm going to continue using it going forward. I know a lot of people think that it's a little bit hard to learn, but I think once you put in a little bit of time to mastering how it works, I think it's actually going to make your life a lot easier. And actually creating custom headers and footer is actually really, really nice and easy using the Flexbox container. I do have another tutorial on that. I'll leave it somewhere in the description box below. And I also have another video showing you how to convert your old website to Flexbox container, how to do it the right way. I have another video for that. I will also leave it in the comment section below. So let me know what you think about the Flexbox containers. Let me know in the comment section below. Are you using it, or are you waiting for Elementor to officially release the Flexbox containers? Or is it too complicated for you to use? You prefer using sections, columns, and inner sections? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel already, go ahead and do that. Smash the like button so that more people can see this video. And don't forget to click on the bell notification icon so you get notified when next I upload a video like this. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.